Hi, myself Dr. Avinash Dwivedi, professor in Department of Computer Science and Engineering, GEMS, Greater Noida. Today we will discuss about Java arrays in Java programming. And these are some topics which we will cover. Input in programming language. When we are running any program or we are developing any application for any program or any means application, we require algorithm as well as input. How we are giving input to that program? Because without giving any input, we cannot expect any output. So input giving is important, and to give input to a system or to any algorithm, we need to define some variables, and we give value to those variables, and that variables are used in programming or in algorithm. So if there are two variables required to add two numbers and third one is required to get the output of that, so we require three variables to process addition of two numbers. So there are three variables which are needed in addition program. But if there are hundreds of inputs which we want to give, then 100 variable or more than that variables are very difficult to manage. We cannot manage more number of variables with different names. So this creates lots of problem to remember, to recall, to use those variables are quite difficult task. So there is one concept of arrays that came in picture, and in arrays there is one name and different indices. Using that you can store many values with single name, and we can use that very effectively and efficiently. So in this example, we have mentioned integer a and then square bracket equal new integer 100. So what it does, it creates 100 locations where we can use or store 100 different values of same type. So only one name is here, but how we can store different numbers using different indices. So what is Java array? Java array provides a data structure, the array, which stores a fixed size sequential collection of elements of the same type. The condition of using array is we need to use only same type of data type. Means we cannot store data of different types. So to store more values, we can use array. And in fact, most of the collection types in Java, which are the part of java.util package, and its APIs or functions has been given in java.util package. And array is an object that is created during the execution time. So it is dynamic, and once you are creating object that is array, you need to fix its size. So what we can define, we can say Java is collection of similar data types, or we can say array is a container object that hold values of homogeneous type. The size of an array is fixed and cannot be increased to accommodate more element. Once its size has been declared, then you cannot modify that. And its index starts with 0. If we mention array of size 10, then it starts with A0 up to A9. Then 10 values can be stored there. But it is very difficult to add value in the middle of an array, or difficult to delete that value. It's a little bit complex process. And whenever we use array in Java, then index starts from 0 to size minus 1. In this slide, we can see there are 6 values which we want to store, that is x0, x1, x2, x3, x4, x5 are different variables, and we are storing different values. And how we can do this in any array? We are defining an array name x, and just varying their index, we can store different values. And how Java is different from C++ while handling array? In array, we can use length property while evaluating its size. In C++, we use size of operator to calculate, to count how many elements are there in array. But in Java, we can use length property to count how many values are there in an array. And Java array is an object that is dynamically generated. And in object-oriented programming, we need to perform serialization, and we need to create clone. So Java arrays are very suitable in both the processes. And in C++, we can also create single dimension or multi-dimensional array, and similarly we can create in Java also. And in C++, we can create anonymous arrays, we can create anonymous arrays, but that is not possible in C++. An array in Java without any name is anonymous array. So how do we manage array in memory? So we mention only one name, and it can store primitive types as well as it can store different objects of similar type. And if we mention it, say of size 5, so there will be 5 locations, and indexes are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Suppose the name of the array is A, then A0 will contain 1, A1 is containing 3, A2 is containing 8, A3 is containing 23, A4 is containing 99. So this is the process to store value in memory. In this program, we can see there is a class and an array. A first array has been created here by using new keyword, and its size is mentioned 6. So it can store 6 values of same kind. And in for loop, we are using length property. So array name dot length will count how many elements are there in the array, and we are initializing here. So how we are initializing any array? A first array and I is working as index equal I plus 1. So I plus 1 is the value which we are allocating to particular location. And similarly for writing loop, we can print that value using indices. Features of array. It is always index, and index becomes between 0 to size minus 1 of the array. And we can store similar data types, and it can occupy contiguous memory locations. That is why we can access or call different stored values of array by using indexes also only. Arrays are object. So in Java, everything is object except primitive data type. So arrays are also objects. They can even hold reference variables of objects. Means it stores primitive data types as well as objects. And they are creating or storing values at runtime. They are dynamic in nature, and array is an object, that is why it get created in heap, and we can measure array of length. So what is advantage and disadvantage of Java array? So first of all, we will talk about advantage. Code optimization is possible with the help of array, because we have sorted array. If things are sorted, then efficiency of algorithm can be increased, and there is random access, so we can reach to any location without any delay. What is this advantage of array? Once its size is fixed, then we cannot modify that. We need to stop the program, then we can change. And automatically, growth is not possible in Java array. Then point comes, how to declare any array. As we know, there are 8 types of primitive data which is present in Java. We can create array of primitive types as well as object, and based upon the structure, arrays are of two types: single dimensional array and multi-dimensional array. In single dimensional array, how we mention data type, then square bracket, and then the name which we want to give array. So in this slide, the name is ARR, which is mentioned. So what is the array name here? ARR. And what value it will contain depends upon what is its data type. So these three are the ways by using that we can declare any array as single dimensional array. So at one place, a square bracket is present just before the array name. In second, square bracket is towards array name. And in third case, means square bracket is at third place. So how can we declare any array variable? So we can declare in both the ways. One is, in first line we are declaring int array. So int is a data type, and the name of the array is int array. In this statement, we are declaring any array variables. And Java arrays as a fixed static field, a local variable, or permanent, just like any other variables. You can make its use as per your requirement. An array is simply a variable of the data types instead of being a single variable of that type. It is a collection of variables of that particular type. So if you want to declare a string array, you can also. And if you want to create array of object, then you mention class name that becomes data type, square bracket, and any name you can give. So here my class is an user defined data type, and you are creating one array, my class array of user defined data type. So this array will store objects of my class. So how many means number of objects you are interested to store, you can store in this array. So if we take example of different types of array in single dimension, we can store integer values, string values, double, float, or whatever objects we want to store with the help of an array. Now the point comes how to initialize any value, because once we declare any variable, we need to instant means initialize that. Initialize meaning what value you are going to store at that location. So in array creation also, in first line you have created one int array of integer type, and you are mentioning here 10. It means you are mentioning or storing 10 variables. So 10 values it can store, and it is instantiating. So before initialization, we need to instantiate any variable with object name. So what is mentioned here? When we write int array equal new int 10, it means it will create an array of size 10, and after using new keyword, it will instantiate an object of type integer, and now you can store value. So there are different types of arrays which you are creating, like string array, array, double array, or array of any object. So instantiation of array we can do using new keyword in this example, and this is another method. Without mentioning its size, you can directly give values. So this will also instantiate an array of integer. And string creation is also possible. Means in last line you can see we are creating one array of a string, and that is having values 1, 2, 3. So this is the latest feature. We need not to write new keyword while instantiating any array. And both the options are up to user, what options user is following. Now point is how to initialize any array. To initialize any value, we need variable name, and since it is an array, so we need to mention its index and then equal to its value. So this will assign a value. Like in this line we can see there is integer int array 1 equal to. It means 2 will be stored at second location of int array. So you can initialize array index with different values of array. And how do we access that value in your program? You mention array name and then you mention index of that, and you can use that. See, in this example, we are using one class, and that class has main method. And in first line of method, we are mentioning that our array A will contain 5 elements. So instantiation is taking place, and after instantiation, we initialize different locations of array A by using assigning operator. And after assignment, we can use those values. And in this program, we have used length property to measure length of an array. And after running this loop, we can print what values have been stored in array. Our point is how to declare, instantiate, and initialize Java array. So we can use new operator as well as without new operator. So in this case, what we are doing, we are declaring any array, and we are initializing simultaneously. So this array A will contain four values: 33, 3, 4, and 5. We write data type, then variable name, square bracket, equal curly braces, and we mention the values which we want to store in array. So dynamically it will take size of 4. We are not mentioning here, but it takes the size. Similarly, in this program, we are creating an array and we are using. Now we talk about multi-dimensional array. In single dimension array, there is one row and many columns. Means we mention only one bracket that shows that array contains only one row. But if size has been mentioned 4, it means one dimensional array is having one row and four columns. And in multi-dimensional array, that may be two-dimensional, three-dimensional, or n-dimensional. So in two-dimensional, we can mention how many rows are there. That first bracket tells, and second bracket tells how many columns are there. So how many values we can store. So if we mention 3x4 matrix, it means that matrix contain 3 rows and 4 columns. So that array will store 12 values. So in this two-dimensional array declaration, how we declare an array of two dimension? We mention data type, then double square brackets must be there, and array name. And you can initialize, I means instantiate two-dimensional array using data type, double square bracket, and then array name equal new data types, and double square bracket. In first one, you will mention how many rows you want, and in second one, how many columns you want. So if we see two-dimensional array, see we can show element using two means notations. First notation of square bracket will tell about your row, and second about its column. So in this matrix, there are 3 rows and 3 columns. So 9 values you can store in this particular array. And if you want to create an array of size 3x2, it means 3 rows and 2 columns. How you write? You write its data types, then array name equal new int 3x2, means In first square bracket you mention 3 and in second you mention 2. As you have initialized in single dimension, you do the same process in multi-dimension also. So for first location, like first row and first column, that is 0, 0, and you are initializing with 1, and for second one means your 0th row and first column equal array name first row and 0th column, it stores 0 value. Similarly, in second row, the index is 1, and first column you are initializing 1. So this way you can initialize any point of two-dimensional array. So in this program we have initialized two-dimensional array. First we have created an array of size 2 cross 2, it means 2 rows and 2 columns, and then we are initializing values, and we can see output also how it comes. And this is a second way to store any two-dimensional array. We can simply see in the example, and how we, without using any new keyword, we are declaring as well as initializing. So if we take the last line, that contains an array of integer type. So there is mentioning of integer, double square bracket, then two dimensional array name equal, one curly braces, and first part of the outer curly braces contains one, means opening and closing curly braces, that contains 1, 2, 3, and second is containing 4, 5, 6. So in first row we will store 1, 2, 3, and in second row we will store 4, 5, 6. In this example, again we are using an array and which has 3 different tuples in an curly braces. So how, what it declares? It declares it contains 3 rows, and in every rows there is elements, and how many elements are there in a row? 2 elements are there. Like three dimension means two dimensional array, we can have any dimensional array. So if we talk about three dimensional array, so again it has 3 square brackets. First square bracket tells how many tables or arrays in three dimensional array, and second number will show how many rows are there, and third will show how many columns are there. So while mentioning three dimensional array, we use 3 square brackets first, and if we talk about the first line, what it shows, it will show that there will be 2 tables, 3 rows and 4 columns. And we initialize 3 dimensional array same as 2 dimensional array. We will understand this with the help of this program. In this program, how we have written? We have written integer, triple square bracket, and then its name equal, curly braces, and its parts are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Means it tells there are 3 different values we can store. So we are in this, we are using three tables and three rows and three columns, and we can initialize that. So first array will contain element 1 2 3, second will 4 5 6, and third one is 7 9 8 9. In this slide, we are using three-dimensional array, and we are storing set of three tables. And one set contains 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6. Second set contains 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, and third set contains 1, 8, 27, 64, 125, 216. So what is meaning of this? In first set, yani in first table, there will be two rows and all three columns. So first column will contain 1, 2, 3, and second row will contain 4, 5, 6. So in this way of writing 3D values, we are using three arrays, and one array is of dimension 2 cross 3, and second array is containing 2 cross 3, and third one is also 2 cross 3. So in this way we can use three dimensional array. So as far as array is concerned, array has solved many problems. With the same name, you can store similar data types of any types. It may be a primitive types, or you can store objects, with its limitation that once you have created your array, then you are not eligible to change its size. And in between, inclusion and deletion is little bit tough in array. So using arrays, we can make our programming simple, and we are able to pass values in a simple manner. Thanks a lot.